Every winter, Pierce County does a point-in-time homeless count to better understand the size and makeup of our homeless population. This year, the county is looking for several volunteers to make it possible. Joining me today is Tess Colby. She is with Pierce County Community Connections. Tess, first of all, what is the homeless count that you're doing?
So every year across the country, communities do a one-night point-in-time count. And the purpose of the count really is to find out how many people are homeless. But it's more than just that. We also want to know who's homeless. Are they families with children, vets, single adults, youth? We want to know where they are, and we want to get a sense of who they are, what their needs are, so we can provide services to them. So this year in Pierce County, the point-in-time count will take place on January 29th.
And so I understand that you need some volunteers and you need them quick.
We do. We need about 200 volunteers across the county to help us with the count. As I said, it's on January 29th. The day is from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. And the shifts are about 2 to 3 hours. There are shifts all during that day. And volunteers will have a variety of opportunities. They may want to work in any one of a number of events that are happening during the day. There's also surveys and data collection that happens in clinics, in shelters, in food banks, or they may pair up with an outreach professional and actually go out into targeted neighborhoods.
And will there be training available for these people?
Yes, there absolutely will be. We are conducting training between now and January 25th in various locations across the county. The training lasts about 90 minutes, and they will learn how to conduct the survey. The survey asks questions about where people spent the night before, how long they've been homeless, and we collect demographic information. And so the training gets people prepared for that. They'll be able to do a mock survey during the training. You know, this volunteer opportunity is really important. It's critical for us so that we can gather this information. But really, it's engaging with another human being. So a lot of times, people who are homeless really don't feel seen or heard. So a big part of the volunteer experience is listening compassionately and engaging with people.
It sounds like a really rewarding thing for a volunteer to do.
I think it is. And it's a lot of our volunteers come away and they say that they have a much better understanding of the crisis and how hard it is for folks who are experiencing homelessness to really get through day by day. They feel as though they're giving back to their community in a really meaningful way. You know, we use this data internally at the county to help us make sure that the dollars that we have, the federal and state dollars, get allocated to programs that can provide housing and support services. So really, the point in time count is our first step at truly ending homelessness in the county.
And what should people do if they'd like to get involved?
They should give us a call. Valerie Pettit in Community Connections, our department, is coordinating the count, and I think her phone number is going to be on the screen. So give us a call, and we can then help connect people to the appropriate training.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you.